Hey everybody, this is Tony with Titan Applicators here at our home base, and today we have the honor and the privilege of having the National Roof Market Manager, did I get that right?
Yes, you did.
For North Carolina Foam Industries, NCFI Polyurethanes, Mr. Butch Mackey. Thanks for being with us today.
No, thanks for having me.
One of the things that I have been explained on how to do, I have a general idea and understanding of how to do it, but I've never seen it done, is to foam density check. Anytime that we've ever needed a density check, we've always sent it to the chemist over at NCFI. But today, Mr. Mackey is going to be explaining to us how to go about doing that and formulating to get those results. So Butch, could you kind of run us through exactly what you're going to be doing here?
Well, sure. First of all, you know, density is measured in pounds per cubic foot. We're not going to have a cubic foot of foam that we're going to in turn weigh. So we take a sample of the foam and we have to figure out what the displacement of this sample is. So first thing what we'll do is we'll weigh this small sample here, which comes in at 8 grams. Then we will check the displacement. Ordinarily we'll be using a beaker, but in the field most contractors are not going to have a beaker with them. So we just pick this up at a container store. It's marked and measured in milliliters. It's not marked in individual 1 milliliter increments, but this will get us close enough so that the contractor has some idea of what he's doing. This becomes somewhat important, particularly for guys like you operating in Denver, as you go up in elevation, the density of the foam tends to get lighter. So at NCFI, we manufacture foams that are low altitude and high altitude formulations, so that when we get up to higher elevations, we're still meeting our density requirements, or at least getting as close to them so that we're within the guidelines of, and the specifications on our data sheet. So we simply will take the foam and put it in, and we'll put it down, and you want to get it to where it's just at the top of the, and of course the foam is very buoyant, so it doesn't want to do this. Take the weight of the sample, in this case 8 grams, and multiply it by the amount of displacement, which was 175 milliliters, and that gave us 0.0457. We multiply that by 1,000, which gave us 45.7, that's kilograms per cubic meter. We divide that by 16, and that gives us our density of 2.85 pounds per cubic foot. This was a 2.8 pound foam. It came in at 2.85. I think that's pretty darn close.
And I think as we previously discussed while the camera was off, we actually owe you money.
Yes, so I'll take lunch.